So here's the first question. Do I read it out?
One is the answer, I think.
Yes.
One? Everybody goes with one?
One.
Great. So I'm glad everybody has the definition of sustainability right in their heads. So with that, next.
Bye.
Yes, anybody?
Option one.
Okay. One, everybody?
Yes.
Great. Buying, because all the practices say the three R's: reuse, recycle, and reduce. Right. Next question: most energy used by human comes from option one, the sun; option two, the earth; and option three, water.
Option two, the earth.
Okay.
No, sorry. One. Energy. This is energy, na? Sun.
One.
Yes.
Most energy used by human.
Second.
All
the energy, right? As they are producing the energy.
I'll say third. I don't want to water feel left out.
Okay, great. Let's move on to the answer and get to know what the real answer is. It's the earth.
Wow.
I've been using the earth resources, and that's why they're depleting now. And now we're moving on to the non-renewable resources, which are the sun and water. Okay. Next question. Which of the following uses less water? Washing a full load of dishes by hand or in the dishwasher?
By hand. By hand is
uses less water.
Yes. One.
Hand. By hand.
Are you sure?
One. Yes, okay. you can actually use the water properly by hand by putting off the tap when required and when not.
Okay. Actually, the correct answer is
dishwasher.
Now, earlier the dishwashers were not that compatible. Now they are energy efficient and water saving. So only a required amount of water is used, and plus it saves energy. That's why the answer is dishwasher. Next question is, what type of supermarket bag is more eco-friendly, paper or plastic?
Paper.
Everybody? One.
Yes.
Paper.
Third. We can buy your own bag.
Unless third. You use them.
Third. It's cloth actually.
Cloth bag.
Yeah, neither of them. Use a cloth bag.
Neither of
them. Yes. Great. I'm glad everybody knows about this.
Right.
So it's neither of them, because paper and plastic both harm the environment, and it's preferable to use the cloth or your own reusable bags. Next question. Appliances that are turned off don't use any electricity. What is it? True or false?
It's false.
False, I guess.
They use passive electricity.
Great. I actually expected Toastmaster probably. Great. It's false. Many appliances continue to use the energy for features like clocks and remote control, even when they're turned off. Next questions. Hybrid cars are slower and less safe than conventional cars. True or false?
True.
True?
True person, yeah.
Anybody else?
No idea.
No, it's false.
It's false. Hybrid cars can be faster and they can be more safer than conventional cars. It's false.
So we'll go with you, Mr. Area Director. Hybrid cars can perform on par or rather better than the conventional. Next question. Approximately how much global electricity output is produced from renewable resources? 5%, 1%, 10%. You can give a guess.
5% maybe.
Okay.
Random guess.
We'll move on to the answer. It's 10%. Only about 10% of the global energy comes from renewables. The rest remaining are from non-renewable resources. Hence, the idea is clear that we must use non-renewable resources now. Next question. During a long trip, you conserve more fuel by driving fast and getting to your destination sooner than you do by getting the speed limit. What is it, true or false?
Speed limit. Speed false. Limit. I drive Mumbai to Pune. Speed limit. Maintain speed.
False.
Okay, great. Everybody is right in this then. We save 15% of fuel by driving within speed limits. Okay, next question. And the last question. How do most humans deal with environmental problems?
No guess about it.
Option one.
Okay.
Great. My mom is saying option two.
Humans actually pretend the problem don't exist, and that's why we're in a crisis. But this year, 2020 has taught us enough and taught us how to deal with situations and how to go about sustainable living. So with that, the message is quite clear, and I would stop sharing. Yes. So with that approach, let us expect the best out of us and move towards sustainable living. And now let us look into the program of today. We have two sessions. The first half will consist of prepared speeches. Speakers will attempt to deliver their speeches based on certain objectives within pre-described time limits, after which there will be evaluations. Here the speeches will be evaluated by senior members who will give their feedback to their respective speakers. The second half will consist of the highlight of the meeting, that is Moments of Truth by our IPP Toastmaster Manpreet. There is one change in the agenda. Please note that our counter is replaced by Toastmaster Hina. Now I will invite someone who is an all-rounder, but professionally she is a software engineer who loves cooking and writing. When asked about the theme, her thoughts towards sustainability are that only sustainability can secure success. So with that, please welcome our Madam President, Toastmaster Hina, for her opening address.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Ishita. Respected Area Director, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests, if we have. A very, very good morning and a very, very happy festive season. Healthy living, healthy environment, healthy economy are all what lead to sustainability. I came across a very beautiful definition of sustainability, which says that sustainability means meeting our own needs without compromising the ability of the future generations to meet their own needs. And that is what we are trying to do today when we talk of sustainability. We save water, we try not to litter on the roads, we try to save our environment. Well, all this is at a very, very high macro level. I'm sorry. What about the micro level? What about Toastmasters Club? What about we as the Toastmasters? As Toastmasters, we are the leaders. We are an employee. We have our own professional and personal life. And only with maintaining our performance levels, only by maintaining our engagement levels, we will sustain, and we have been sustaining for years, and we will for sure sustain for the coming years as well. With this, while our Toastmaster of the day, Yashita, familiarizes us with more on sustainability and how we can be a part of it, let us sit back, relax, and enjoy the magnificent meeting today with our fabulous, fabulous team of role players. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Madam President, for that address. Now let me introduce the role players for today who will help me in the control and conduct of this meeting. First, to keep the track of time, we have a retired civil servant who loves reading. When asked about the theme, his step towards sustainable living would be to bring tiny changes every day, which are environment friendly, with wise use of electricity and repairing and recycling household things, along with eating locally produced foods. With this, please welcome Toastmaster Bhavar. Second role player would be, sometimes we use pauses in our speeches to get an added impact. But these pauses or fillers, on the other hand, can reduce the impact of a speech if used extensively. So to keep the track of these pause fillers, we have a Madam President helping us with that. Please welcome Toastmaster Hina Sharma. Someone else will be observing every single thing that will happen during this meeting. Later, that person will give us the feedback about the proceedings, the environment, and overall general comments. To act as a general evaluator, we have a mechanical engineer. When asked about the theme, his thought towards a sustainable living is that adaptation is the key of sustainability, and he wishes to be more agile in the future. Let's welcome Toastmaster Jaising. Next, to give us the critical feedback of the language, we have somebody who is a manager at IIT MNC. A language evaluator has his views about the theme that his step towards sustainable living would be to stop using non-recyclable products and save natural resources. Let us welcome Toastmaster Shantanu, as he will now introduce the word and the phrase of the day. Over to you, Toastmaster Shantanu.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ishita. Good morning, Madam President, Area Director, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. As a language evaluator for today, I'll be noting down good usage as well as not so good usage of English language that is used in the meeting, and I'll provide their meanings and correct usages. Let me introduce you to the word of the day and phrase of the day. Can you all see my screen?
Yes.
Thank you. So today's word of the day is discretion. It's a noun and it's pronounced as discretion. Meaning of word of the day is the freedom to decide what should be done in particular situation. Example is, sales staff were given discretion to offer customers a 10% discount. Anybody would like to try word of the day?
Toastmaster of the day has a discrimination throughout the meeting.
Thank you. Yes, Toastmaster Vinod.
Yeah, nowadays we are getting so many messages to attend meetings on Zoom. It is our discretion which to attain, which not.
Thank you. That was a good usage. I'll go ahead with the phrase of the day. Today's phrase of the day is sweep under the carpet. Meaning of it is to hide a problem or to try to keep it secret instead of dealing with it. Example of this is, the committee is being accused of sweeping financial problems under the carpet to avoid embarrassment. Anybody would like to try phrase of the day?
Maharashtra police were trying. Lot of people are thinking that Maharashtra police is trying to sweep under the carpet of Sushant Singh. So they are planning to transfer the case to the CBI.
Thank you. That was very well relevant. Anybody else? Okay, it was Master Hina.
Our sustainability is at our discretion. So let's not sweep our problems and issues under the carpet.
Okay, awesome. You used word of the day, phrase of the day both. Toastmaster Jay Singh.
As a role of the general evaluator, I should do justice with my role and should not sweep anything under the carpet.
Thank you. That was one more good usage. The last one, Toastmaster Vinod.
Yeah. In our nearby building, there was one corona positive. Their family hide the information and kept swept under the carpet.
Okay, awesome. Thank you, sir. I urge everyone to use word of the day and phrase of the day generously. To encourage use of word of the day and phrase of the day, please give thumbs up to someone who uses word of the day, phrase of the day. Feel free to use a reaction on Zoom, and I'll come back later to present my report. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Shantanu. Moving ahead, the first half consists of two prepared speeches. Each speech has a specific time limit and certain fixed objectives. That's why we call it a project. Each project teaches us some aspect of public speaking, such as body language or vocal variety or persuasive skills. The speakers will try to learn various such aspects in their speeches. After all the prepared speeches, we will have the voting for the best speaker. To qualify for the voting, the speaker must speak for the minimum time allowed for the meeting and must not exceed the maximum time. However, a grace period of 30 seconds will be given. Our first speaker will attempt Pathway Dynamic Leadership Level 3, Project 2, the Social Speech. Evaluator for the speech is Toastmaster Prabdeep. I request Toastmaster Prabdeep to read the objective of the speech.
Good morning, everyone. The objective of Pawan's speech today is the purpose is for the member to practice delivering social speeches in front of club members. We will be attempting the project deliver social speeches first, our speech from the Pathways manual. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmaster Prabdeep. Time allowed is 5 to 7 minutes. That means the lighting sequence will be green at 5 minutes. Yellow at 6 minutes and red at 7 minutes. The buzzer will sound at 7.5 minutes. The title of the speech is Booklet Guy. The speaker is a software engineer and has recently started online organic grocery business. He loves reading and listening to ghazals. When asked about the theme, his step towards a sustainable living would be roti, rosy, meaning wife, and reading. With this, let's welcome Toastmaster Pawan.
Thank you, TMOD. Can you hear me?
Yes.
And can you see me as well?
Yes.
Can you see my hand movement?
We cannot see you.
Can you see me now?
No, yes.
Pawan, actually, before you start, let me confirm the timings again, because Ishita said it's 5 to 7 minutes, but on the evaluation, it's 3 to 4 minutes.
Yeah, it's 3 to 4 minutes, correct.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It's 3 to 4 minutes. Three at green at 3, and 3.5 will be shown as yellow, and red at 4 minutes, right?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thank you.
Raise your hand if you are interested in reading. You can use the emotions which are on the Zoom screen. I can see quite a few hands. I'm too busy. I have lots of work that's piled up. I have so many things to take care. The excuses are endless to sweep under the carpet. Isn't it? Madam President, fellow Toastmasters, area directors, and dear guest, very good morning. I know we all are busy. We are in our own discretion to decide what to do and what not. But in today's world, where the knowledge is the key, reading stands out at the topmost. I know we are all busy, and we have decided many times that I should start reading soon, but it doesn't happen. What if there is someone who narrates the whole book for you, who reads book for you, and you have to quietly listen it? Isn't that sound interesting? Oh, I know. You are too much busy. You don't want to listen the entire book. What if someone just narrates the summary of the book? Isn't that sound more interesting? There is a guy whose name is Amrut Deshmukh, and he is popularly known as Booklet Guy. Amrut on his way to make India read on mission. He is a chartered accountant by profession, a TEDx speaker, and of course a passionate reader. The thing started when he was trying to tell some story to his friend after reading the book. I can see some disturbances, sorry about. So he started to narrate the story to the book. This particular incident took turn in his life, and he found the purpose in his life. Amrut thought that to utilize his skill of narration and reading together, and to help the people and motivate and imbibe the and cultivate the habit of reading amongst his friends. He narrated few stories and gave it to or distributed on the WhatsApp. Within a few weeks, thousands of people approached him, and he shared all the stories to them. To his surprise, he found that only 10% of the people read the message through the WhatsApp. So he went back and thought, oh, that's the thing. So what he did is he started recording the speeches or narrating the stories in his own voice and started uploading. With his few IT friends, he created a book app called as a booklet. And he made a promise that he should upload a summary of one book every week. Today, more than 5,000 books have been uploaded to an app called Booklet. To surprise, there are more than 2 million downloads on Play Store and App Store for the Booklet app. I urge each one of you to go download and start the journey towards a great leader. Remember, as we said, padhega India to badhega India. Thank you, and over to you, TMOD.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pavan. Let us pause for 1 minute to write the feedback for the speaker. Giving feedback is very important as it helps him to improve in the next speech. You're requested to write the feedback personally in the chat box or later through WhatsApp. Let us move on to the next speaker. Our second speaker will attempt Pathway Presentation Mastery Level 3, Project 2, Evaluation. No, I'm mistaken on this. Just a moment. Presentation Mastery Level 3, Project 2, Deliver Social Speech. Evaluator for this speech is distinguished Toastmaster Vinod. I request him to read the objective of the speech.
The objective of the speech are same as what Prabdeep read, but it is my discretion to read or not. So I am using my discretion, I am reading the purpose. The purpose of the project is for the member to practice, deliver a social speech in front of all the club members. All the best to my speaker.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vinod. The timing for the same is the timing for the speech is same as the previous speech, hence would not be repeated. The title of the speech is My Friend's Marriage. The speaker is an engineer who loves reading and traveling. When asked about the theme, his step towards a sustainable living would be to start optimal usage of natural resources. Let's welcome Toastmaster Abhinav.
Hello, am I Vijayan?
Yes.
Good morning, everyone. We have gathered here to celebrate wedding of these two lovers, Mr. and Mrs. Pandey. I hope you are all having a wonderful time. I know groom Kamalakant Pandey from nursery class. We have been friends for 25 years. We studied in same school, we went to same college, and we used to live in same street. After 12th class, we moved to different cities. But he was always present in my childhood memories. I remember few incidents. Once in my office, people were talking about some entrepreneurship, organic farming, etc. I told, it is nothing. My childhood friend Kamalakant and I took loan of 10 potatoes from my mother and sow in the field. Output yield potatoes we sold in the market and had Italy with from that money. Once I went to movie Jindgi Na Milegi Dobara with my office friends. As usual, next day we were talking about that movie. I told, it is nothing. One day my childhood friend Kamalakant called me and told, Abhinav, catch the train for Mount Abu, which was scheduled 2 hours from my space. And he told that he would join me along the same train. Our two of other gang joined us wagon from Ahmedabad. We spent 3 days in Mount Abu. And that trip became one of the memorable trip. Once in my office, we were planned one track to Sandan Valley. We went to Sandan Valley track, and as usual, we were talking about that track in over coffee. And we were talking, then I told them, it is nothing. My childhood friend Kamalakant and I used to wander in nearby forest. We used to take bath in river. We used to feed ourselves with all sorts of fruit like guava, custard apple, etc. Not only that, we even used to collect all fruits in our shirts and bring it to home for everyone. Those were indeed some beautiful and carefree days. Currently, I talk to Kamalakant once in a month. Maybe from next month onwards, we'll talk quarterly once, but Kamalakant will always remain in my stories. I would like everyone to raise their glass and congratulate Mr. and Mrs. Pandey. Cheers. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhinav. Let us pause for 1 minute to write the feedback for the speaker. Toastmaster Bhavar, can we have the timer's report now? Can you give us the exact timings of the two speakers?
Yes, yes. First, the sergeant at arms, Anupam Arora, 3.55. And Gita Sharma.
You could give us only the timings for the two speeches.
Two speeches only. This Pavan Deshpande, 3.57. Okay. And Abhinav Prasad, 3.25.
Okay, thank you. This means that both the speakers are qualified for the voting?
Yes.
Okay. Here's the poll. You can vote for the best speaker. Toastmaster Hina, are we done with the voting?
Yeah, we have, I think, a couple of people. I think we are done, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Let us move on to the evaluations part now. The two evaluators will give their written as well as oral feedback to the speaker at the end of the meeting, but they will also give some feedback in here for 2 to 3 minutes. The timing sequence is green at 2 minutes, yellow at 2.5 minutes, and red at 3 minutes. The buzzer will be sound at this. Let us welcome Toastmaster Prabhdeep.
Toastmaster today, fellow Toastmasters, dear guest, Ms. President, good morning to everyone. Toastmaster Pawan, a very good speech delivered today. Your objective was to deliver a social speech, and you chose the format of eulogizing someone to honor an individual, and it fit within the objective of this speech. It was a great speech. I especially liked the tone in which you were speaking. It came out more because you know there was a problem with your video, and I could really hear that your voice is quite effective at conveying all the emotions you have. But in the same vein, I would like to say please keep care of your video, because your video was like 90% of the time it was jammed, it was frozen. I couldn't see your face or your gestures, so that compromised the quality of his speech. But that's a technical issue that can be taken care of in the next time. So coming back to the objective of the speech, since you talked about Amrit, who used to narrate stories and later created an app, and that's how he ended up, through him, there was a lot of social, he helped socially people to, read more books and to change their lives. So that was a good approach. You selected a person who needed to be praised. But the thing is that the format in which we, execute these kind of speeches is the kind of live format. You should pretend that the person is actually present in the meeting. So don't think that you are in a Toastmaster meeting. You can make believe that you are in a wedding, like Abhinav did, or you can pretend that you are actually eulogizing someone at certain gathering. So you don't have to be in a Toastmaster meeting. So that was the point of delivering the social speech. You are in a social scenario where you are eulogizing a person. So that part was missing. Maybe you didn't know that. So you have another second part of the project. You can take care of that the next time. Everything else was spot on. No further improvement or feedback points. Just keep take care of your video from the next time. And yeah, best of luck for the next time. Thank you very much. Over to you, Toastmaster Ishita.
Thank you, PM Prabhdeep.
Thank you, Toastmaster Prabhdeep. The second speech by Toastmaster Abhinav will be evaluated by someone who is into logistics for 33 years now and who loves reading books and making new friends and dancing. When asked about the theme, his step towards a sustainable living would be to work hard and to make it a point to save minimum 30% of his earning, as it would help in sustaining life. Let us welcome distinguished Toastmaster Vinod.
Mr. Area Director Joy, Madam President, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, good morning. And a special good morning to my speaker, Toastmaster Abhinav. What a great speech Abhinav delivered. Well, before the meeting, he was adjusting his camera, his voice, and he was totally standing from the before the meeting, and he delivered the speech by standing, and that is a great signs of a great speaker. His hand gestures were fantastic. Using his hand gesture is another express his views. So he spoke about his friend's marriage, Kamlesh Pandey, Mr. and Mrs. Kamlesh Pandey, and he raised a toast. It's a description how you can deliver the social speeches. There are four ways: raising a toast, speaking an acceptance speech, that accepting an award. Then the other speech is to honor an individual, and a speech to honor an organization. So he used his discretion and chose to speech to raise a toast. As I said, he spoke about the friend from the childhood, then college days, and then about his marriage and everything. The preparation was well good. As I said, he was from the beginning, he was standing and delivered the speech. He spoke everything about his Toastmasters. His hand gestures were good. And he was so confident and delivered the 3 to 4 minute speech. This was good about the speech. Now, what are the recommendations from my side? This speech is to raising a toast. And when I got the title, my friend's marriage, so I thought he will speak about the friend's marriage in detail, right? So there was a little bit confusion as far as my opinions are concerned. And suddenly at the end of the day, he raised the toast, right? So there was a little bit confusion whether he is honoring his friend or raising a toast. There are two different social speeches. Preparation. Today morning, since he was good prepared, but what about for the last 7-8 days? He forgot the speech. He forgot the speech and then he recalled. So preparation is a very much for the every speech to deliver the speech. So these things you cannot sweep under the carpet, right? So you have to prepare well. Overall, a great speech, good hand gestures, good voice modulation. And if you prepare well and deliver the speech, it will be you can give a great speech for the next over to Toastmaster of the Day. Sorry, I could not see the timing card, sir.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Vinod. We will now have the timer's report. Toastmaster Bauer, could you tell us the exact timings of the evaluators?
Prabhdeep has taken 2.48 and Vinod Sharma has taken 3.14 minutes.
Okay. Thank you. Which means both the evaluators have qualified for the voting. Now we can have the poll for the best evaluator.
The best speaker reading.
Toastmaster Hina, could you please let me know when I could start again?
Yes, I'm waiting. Okay, so we are done, Arishka.
Thank you. It's time now for the language evaluator to come forward to give his comments and present his report. Let us welcome Toastmaster Shantanu.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Ishita. We just had two speeches today, so not much time to evaluate, but our word of the day and phrase of the day were used many times. So any guesses how many times roughly it was used today? Okay, it was used around 12 times by Sergeant at Arms Anupam, Toastmaster of the day Ishita, President Hina, Toastmaster Vinod, Toastmaster Damaji, Toastmaster Jai Singh Pavan. So let's congratulate them with applause. Thank you. Now I'll highlight not so good usage of language. So somebody said, isn't that sound more interesting? So I think that could have been said as, doesn't that sound more interesting? Somebody said, speak in detail. It could have been speak in detail. There was also usage like we were planned outing. It could have been we had planned outing. In general, some pronunciations could have been better. I would suggest everyone to use Google for that. You can just Google the word. There is a pronunciation. There is a speaker icon there. You can just click it and hear how to pronounce the word. Now I'll highlight the good usage of English. Someone mentioned, let's expect the best. That was one of the good use. Then somebody said macro and micro level. And someone also said spot on and raise a toast. So those were good usage of language. I thank you and I hope everyone keeps making good usage of grammar and their vocabulary to communicate clearly and effectively. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster today.
Thank you, Toastmaster Shantanu. We will now have the R counter report by Toastmaster Hina.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ishita. Let me just... I'm pinning... I cannot spotlight myself. Anyways, talking about the R counter report, we had our Sa Anupam having 3 R's and 2 UMs. Speaker 1 and speaker 2. They did not have any pauses as such, but they had a little pause during the sentences while they were speaking. Mostly for Pavan, it was like if a sentence is, you know, she was trying to tell a story, it was... you know, read out as she was trying to. So there were pauses in the sentence, but no R's and UMs as such. For speaker 2, I think he had a long pause while he was trying to remember. That is it. Prabdeep had 5+ R's. Our second evaluator, Vinod Sharma, was flawless. Our language evaluator, Shantanu, had 5+ R's. Timer was flawless. Okay, so our flawless speakers for today are DTM Vinod and Toastmaster Rishita. Let's have a round of applause for them. And yeah, otherwise we are good. So short report today. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day, Rishita.
Thank you, Toastmaster Hina. Before I go on to the general evaluator, I would request everybody to rename themselves if they're Toastmasters or guest. Guest could rename themselves as guest and then their name. It would help us for tracking attendance. And moving on, someone was observing the proceedings of the entire meeting.
So I will start with the Sergeant at Arm, Toastmaster Anupam. You started the meeting on time. You narrate our club mission, explained very well. The theme was very much clear. Only one point I want to highlight here. First thing, if you want to move from your place, then please switch off your video. And the second point, in the presentation or the slides, please keep the text little bit bigger so that people can see. Thank you very much. Overall, good job. Next is presidential address, perfect, related to the theme, full of energy and very much to the point with the theme. Next, I will not evaluate the speakers because they are already evaluated. Toastmaster of the day, that I will come back later. Toastmaster Bhava, timer. So you missed to show the cards 2 times with the evaluation. And there were few seconds of the lag for the speakers also. So maybe you can correct it later. Overall, a good job. You are present and the timings you had explained very well. No issue. Now the next is the grammarian, Toastmaster Shantanu. You did really a good job today. That word of the day, phrase of the day, you explained really very well. Used by a lot of people. It was very easy and you explained the details. Kudos to you. No more improvement points. Great job. Our counter, Madam President or Toastmaster Hina, you explained it very well. No recommendation. All perfect. Now, evaluators. Evaluator 1, you have used the, both evaluators use the CRC approach. But evaluator 1, you will put lot of efforts on the video freezing, which you can take up in the other side also, or maybe offline. You highlight, definitely important, but maybe you can spend less time on it. Overall, a good job. Distinguished Toastmaster Vinod, evaluator 2, you evaluated the speech for Toastmaster Abhinav. You explained all the good requirements for the speeches and you highlighted the issues also. Kudos to you overall. And Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ishika. The theme was very much relevant. All were very much in love with the theme and the topic. The flow was really good, excellent. So only 1 point or the 2 points I want to highlight here. The speech. Timings for the speech 1 was wrong. So maybe you can correct me. Take care for the later. And the second, the slides which you have prepared, maybe the text is bigger than it's easy to see. Overall, a great meeting. Only 1 point I want to highlight here because it's very much important, the agenda. Agenda was delayed by 3 days. So maybe next time the TMOD should take care about it. Overall, fantastic, no doubt on this. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ishika. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Jay. It's now time for recognizing the excellence of our best speakers, evaluators, and role players. Let us invite Toastmaster Hina, our president, to give away the certificates to the winners.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Okay, so before I proceed, let's have guest feedback. We have Atul who has joined us today. Atul, would you like to share your experience of how you liked the meeting and any improvement points that you feel?
Yes, I joined today's meeting. I came across your club meeting through a post on Instagram. I'm very glad that I joined the meeting today. Nice. I witnessed many good practices like taking a minute to write feedback for the speakers. This will surely help them. I'll try to incorporate the same practice in my club. And overall, it was a very good session, a bit different, but I learned many things from it.
Great, great. Nice to have you here, Atul. Okay, do we have any more guests with us today? I see Dhareshwar Sontakke. Hello, Dharishu. Would you like to speak and say us a few words of your experience with the meeting today? You are muted, if you're there. Okay. So we'll wait till Dharishwar is there. We also have our area director, Joylin, joining us today. Hello, Joylin. How was the meeting today? Your experiences and your feedback?
Hey, hi. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, Madam President Hina. Good afternoon to all the members and good afternoon to all the guests. First of all, I don't know how you guys do it on a Sunday from 11 to 1. So kudos on that. I've come here for last Sunday and I'm here today and I'm already answering my wife as to what is more important to me. Okay. So kudos to that on that. You guys are really doing very well. What I really loved about, I heard the general evaluator saying that the agenda was delayed by 3 days. Trust me, there are clubs that send agenda just 2 hours before the meeting. So if you all are delayed by 3 days, I don't think there is anything bad, but you guys are doing really well to even send it 3 days in advance and sticking to the agenda. So good work there as well. I think your club has been really amazing. As I've told you all before, also I know quite a few members. Today's evaluations were fantastic. You know, you get to learn so much by coming to your club. I mean, if you have to learn something today, then you need to learn from the evaluation how critical evaluations can be done in a really subtle way and explaining why it is important. So critical evaluation is not only about criticizing a speaker, but it is instead giving a more concrete evaluation by telling them what could have been done better. So that was also done in today's meeting. So wonderful meeting overall. I love coming to your meetings. I've told this before. I think once this whole COVID-19 situation gets over and I'm back in Pune, I'll definitely try and come in person to your meetings as well. I have a lot of good friends from Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest that I miss, but it's really good to see them here as well. Hi, Vinod sir. I think Vinod sir was the division director when I was the president of the club. So yeah, we have, I think it was around 2 years back or 3 years back. So I have a very close touch with him as well. Otherwise, your meeting was really good. I really enjoy coming to your meetings. And I think we have the MOT to follow. So I think we'll discuss more on how your meeting is going there as well. So thank you, Hina. And thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you so much. Bye.
So nice to hear some good words. Thank you, Area Director Joylin. Okay. And I have a few announcements to make. September and October, August, September, as I told you, have the real happening months for this term. So on 30th of August, we have our Speakathon. Please give your names first to book a speech slot with Raghav if you have not yet done so. Our early bird renewals have started. To avail this offer, renew quickly. We'll be sharing the links on the posters on our WhatsApp groups. Do quickly renew yourself and be there for the next term as well. After that, for September, we have our milestone meeting coming on the September 20th. If you have some talent which you can showcase, please send in your nominations if you would like to perform on something for the milestone meeting. Then we have our newsletter also coming up. We request your articles for the newsletter. Any way you would like to contribute to the newsletter, please shoot in your entries as quickly as possible so that we can prepare a beautiful newsletter for the club. On September 27th, mark this date as well. This is our contest date when we have the humorous speech and the evaluation contests. Posters and nominations will open soon. So tune in to our WhatsApp group. Okay, and before I move to the moments of glory, may I please request all to switch on your videos or your video so that we can have a group pic for the club. Quickly, 1 minute. Priya, Vishal, Toastmaster Ritesh, Abhishek. Okay, 10 seconds left. Quickly, all those who are still trying to switch on the videos, please go ahead.
Email and take the photograph as well.
Yes, yes. I'm just waiting for Priya Ruthia, Toastmaster Abhishek, Toastmaster Ritesh. Quickly, I think, yeah.
Madan, your video is not clear. Actually, the virtual background is taking...
Sorry?
One more Sharma is there, Sharma.
I thought it was you. So we have Sharma here. We just see your surname, I'm sorry. If you could switch on your video. Okay, I think Toastmaster Pawan, your video is a little blurred because of the background. And if you can correct that, we are good to take the group pick. Yeah, go ahead. I think let's have something, you know, today's a moment of truth. Ritesh. Are we done, Toastmaster Pawan? Okay. All the smiling faces I've already captured. Perfect. Thank you, Toastmaster Pawan, for the group pick. Okay, and let's move on to the moments of glory. We had a wonderful, wonderful meeting today, but it's time to present our appreciation. For the best role player award, Toastmaster Raghav, you'll be sharing the screen, right? I'm sorry, I cannot see you. Yeah. For the best role player award, we have Toastmaster Eshita. We're making sure that meeting ends in time, for introducing everything in time. Thank you. For the best evaluator, we have DTM Vinod Sharma taking up with the award. Congratulations. And for the best speaker, let us raise a toast to Toastmaster Abhinav for winning the award. Congratulations to all the winners and to all the role players for, you know, having such a great meeting, for having a seamless meeting today. We will now be adjourning the meeting, but we still stay for the moments of truth. And before I end, something on moments of truth that I have, as quoted by Carol Dweck from our club. Okay, Carol Dweck is different. The lines from our club: in a growth mindset, challenges are exciting rather than threatening. So rather than thinking, oh, I'm going to reveal my weaknesses, we say, wow, here's a chance to grow. So we'll now adjourn the meeting. And moving on to moments of truth, we'll be handing over to our IBP Manpreet Kaur, but we adjourn the meeting here. Thanks. Thank you all. Over to you, Manpreet.
Thank you, Toastmaster Hina. So are we like planning to have a 5-minute break before starting the moments of truth? Do we need that? Okay. So we come back by 12:08. It's 12:03 now. So I request none of you all to leave the meeting, please, and stay back. Yeah, we can come back in 5 minutes.
Sure. So,
yes, Pawan.
Toastmaster Manpreet. So when we start this moment of truth, you want me to share the spreadsheet, right, to note down the points.
Not at the start of the MOT, but when we take recommendations during the common discussion that we would have after rating the parameters, then I want you to share this.
Okay, sure.
And also note down the points which would be discussed if we have any recommendations.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. So Zoom Master, please make sure that you give me the presentation rights.
I think it's already on.
Yeah, I can share. Okay, I'll be back in a minute.
All right, we just have a minute to go before MOT. Can I request everybody to be back? I also request everybody to please put on their videos because it's moments of truth and we actually want to see your faces for it. May I know who exactly is Sharma? Is it either of the three Sharmas that we have in our club or somebody else? All right, is everybody back? Can I see a thumbs up for everybody who's in the meeting already? Okay. Great. So let's get started. Well, Mr. Area Director, Madam President, fellow Toastmasters, and our esteemed guests, a very good afternoon to everybody. I am Toastmaster Manpreet, the immediate past president of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest, and I welcome you all to a very important session for all our Toastmasters journey known as the Moments of Truth. And just for you all to know that Moments of Truth happens every 6 months in all the Toastmasters clubs. Now, for the benefit of the guests and for those who are attending the Moments of Truth for the very first time, let me clarify what exactly is Moments of Truth. Each Toastmasters club has its mission to provide a mutually supportive and positive learning experience and environment so that each member can have an opportunity to develop onto their communication as well as leadership skills. This in turn fosters individuals' self-confidence and personal growth. As a club, we want every new as well as prospective members' initial interaction with the club to be a positive one. These decisive times when initial impressions are formed are known as moments of truth. Moments of Truth discusses the standards that are necessary to create a positive impressions about a club and club's services and to provide a club evaluation exercise. A high quality club encourages and celebrates its members' achievements, provides a supportive and fun environment, and offers a professionally organized meeting with variety. In those clubs, officers are trained in all aspects of club quality to ensure that the members have an access to the formal mentoring program, are provided evaluations that help them grow, and are motivated to achieve their goals. When clubs successfully exemplify the moments of truth, members are ensured a safe and supportive environment in which they can achieve their goals. There are 6 critical moments of truth in which clubs have an opportunity to create a positive impression. And these 6 critical moments of truth are: first, impressions, wherein we will focus on welcoming the guests. The second one being membership orientation, wherein helping a new member to get oriented in the club. Number 3 would be fellowship, variety, and communication, that deals with creating a warm, friendly, and supportive environment. 4th one being program planning and meeting organization, wherein planning meetings, well-prepared speakers, and good evaluations will be taken into consideration. 5th one being the membership strength, that is sufficient number of members, recruitment, and retention. And last one being achievement recognition, wherein we'll be tracking the educational progress, recognizing of the success of our members. Now, for all your information, you will all be put in 6 different breakout rooms, and according to your team number, particular points will be discussed and evaluated. The 6 points that I mentioned right now will be, so each one of y'all will be evaluating the club on 1 single parameter. All right. And the rating scale would be from 1 to 5, 1 being we never meet the standard, that is the least. And 5 being the highest, that we always meet that particular standard. Alright. Now, any parameter that you rate the club at 3 or below 3, we expect you to give us a reason and a recommendation for that. Although the 4 and 5 need not require a reason from your end, but in case you have a one-liner or something to suggest the club, if there is any scope for improvement, you can go ahead and do that as well. Now, all the groups would have one spokesperson that would come back and present the report, whatever you'll be rating the club at. And that spokesperson can be anybody. You can decide among yourselves. A guest can also be a spokesperson for that. So that's it from my side. If anybody has any doubts, I can take that now so that before we go out in the breakout rooms, we can clarify your doubts. Do we have any doubts for somebody?
Do you have any attributes to basically give and mark basically? We have 6 category, but okay. For each category, do you have any certain attributes?
Okay. So now I'll be telling you all which breakout rooms you'll be a part of. Also, I've sent a PDF in our official group so that you can refer to it. We have 6 basic parameters and we have sub-parameters in those main points. So at least one of the members of the club would have that PDF with them and you can decide among yourselves who's going to come and present the report. Damaji, you can check the official group for the PDF. But I'll still first tell you all which breakout room you all are a part of. So the first one being first impressions. Please make a note of which breakout room you are going to be in. We have Toastmaster Anupam, Toastmaster Abhishek Negi, and Toastmaster Ishita Sharma in the first breakout room. Then we have Toastmaster Raghav, Toastmaster Anand, Toastmaster Damaji, and Toastmaster Vishal in the second breakout room. Are we clear so far? Then we have Toastmaster Hina, Toastmaster Pavan, and Toastmaster Abhinav in the third breakout room. For the fourth parameter will be assessed by Toastmaster Prabdeep, Toastmaster Shantanu, Toastmaster Ritija, and Toastmaster Bhavasen. Moving on to number 5, we have DTM Vinod Sharma, Toastmaster Ritesh, and Toastmaster Vinoda in the fifth breakout room. And for the sixth one, we have our AD Toastmaster Joylin, Toastmaster Jay, Toastmaster He.
Manpreet, can you share the PDF again
on the official in the chat? It would be a little difficult for me to do that.
Can somebody most of us are on laptop. I don't have access to WhatsApp.
Yeah, I can.
That's the issue with me as well. One second.
I'll just download it. I can.
Prabdeep, anyway, somebody from your group might have
it. I'll download it and put it on the chat right now. Just a second.
All right.
Okay, somebody do small production.
Okay, yeah. Use the phone separately and watch there.
All right, it's there on the chat window as well for the ones who don't have access to WhatsApp. So, do we go in the breakout rooms? Just to tell you all, we would just have 12 minutes to discuss the points. So, make sure you make it quick. The breakout rooms would close exactly after 12 minutes. Okay? So, I'm opening the breakout rooms now.
Hello.
Hello.
I cannot hear you, Toastmaster Hina. I think you are on mute.
Yeah, even I can't hear.
Yeah, sorry. Sorry. Okay. I wanted to see the gallery view. Okay, so four of us are here. What is our topic?
That we need to ask from Manpreet.
She did not tell. She just gave us this only.
Yeah. So just a second.
Ask for help.
Okay, I have an exercise. Just a minute. It might be fellowship, variety, and communication.
Fellowship, variety. Kya? Fellowship mein variety hai kya?
Fellowship, variety, and communication. Guests are greeted warmly and made welcome. Enjoyable. Educational meeting plan, regularly scheduled social event, member participate in area.
आप screen share कर सकते हैं क्या पवन जहाँ पढ़ रहे हैं आप?
हाँ हाँ एक मिनट ये I am helping मंत्री to conduct this meeting. But एक बार double check, let's double check with her.
She's already in the meeting. I can see her.
No, by default.
Ask me for help.
Yes, so we were not knowing that what to discuss.
So, you guys are in which breakout room?
Three.
So, your point is going to be about fellowship, communication, and.
Yep.
Am I right?
Yeah.
So what you have to do is.
Go ahead.
So the point which I mentioned here, guests greeted warmly, made welcome. So you have to rate from 1 to 5 that do we always meet this standard or we don't. So that's the reason I share the PDF as well. It has the best practices also mentioned that we, you can rate us from 1 to 5.
It means good, right? One means worst.
One means worst, 5 being the best.
Okay.
So the thing is, if you're giving it 3 or below, then we will have to give a justification for it. Why are we actually giving it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that too from last 6 months, right?
Yes, from last MOT until today.
Okay.
Okay, we can start. I think now we have only 10 minutes.
Yeah. So can you see my screen now?
Yes, we can see.
Okay. So the points are guest greeted warmly and made welcome.
Can I request somebody to make a note of it? I mean, write it down with themselves when you present it.
I think Pawan will do, na?
Pawan, this is the main thing. We'll update that this Excel sheet. Okay.
I will do that. Okay.
Take one copy then. Yeah. Copy for our group. Hmm.
Okay.
Sure.
Can I leave the breakout room now?
Sure.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, sure. Welcome.
Okay. Yeah. So, guest greeted warmly and made welcome. I think we should rate 5.
Even I would.
No, I don't know. Means for last. No, but Hina, but last 1-2 months, have you seen how many guests are joining our club? It is like nobody is joining, right? Last 1 month, I am not seeing anybody is joining. Percentage is went down.
No, we did have guests joining. I think Nitin Shahane we converted to a member. And then there were a couple of more who are planning to join in. We did have guests, but this is like 6 months ka pura period. Or secondly, how are you greeting the guest? Even if you have 3 guests, how are you greeting?
I don't know. I'm talking about last 1 month. Means when we were going SNBP school, it was very good. But I don't know about last 1 month.
See, this
if
is
it
not
is good, then it is. Means
no, no. See, this point is related to greeting the guest, not related to the membership. So are we increasing the gates? Are we making them arranging educational sessions on that?
Sure. Then it is fine. We are means in meeting, so essay, agree to all the people, yes, and also president grades. Then in that case, it is fine. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So it's like when guests are there, we do acknowledge that guests are there. We talk to them. We have guest briefing session after the meeting. So Akshay,
it is fine.
So just 1 minute, Akshay. This is for your knowledge because this is the first time you are attending MOT.
you have different sections here, right? So we are working on the 23rd row. That is okay. Your fellowship variety. Okay. ये छह points हैं. इन पॉइंट्स को व्हाट वी डू इज वी गिव देम पॉइंट यू नो सपोज गेस्ट ग्रीटिंग ग्रीटेड वार्मली नाउ एज अ मेंबर डू यू थिंक दैट व्हेन गेस्ट जॉइंस आवर मीटिंग्स फॉर द लास्ट सिक्स मंथ्स ओके इट्स नॉट लास्ट यू नो अ कपल ऑफ मीटिंग्स फॉर लास्ट सिक्स मंथ्स डू यू फील दैट व्हेन गेस्ट्स आर जॉइनिंग द मीटिंग वी एक्नॉलेज दैट गेस्ट्स हैव जॉइंड वी टॉक टू देम आफ्टर द मीटिंग वी ऑर्गेनाइज यू नो द गेस्ट ब्रीफिंग सेशन इज दैट सैटिस्फैक्ट्री सो so all these points like fellowships and all bari bari hum aayenge but this is the first point where we are trying to give points okay we agree or we don't agree aisa
okay so basically it's a kind of a feedback session
feedback absolutely okay. Moments of truth ha okay. Okay. What is your feeling do you agree on this so we have given like Pavan has already written points here 5-5
well since this is my second meeting so I can't comment on that but definitely it could I would rate if you ask me I would rate 4
Okay.
Okay.
So you're joining us as a guest here?
Yeah, I've joined as a guest and this is my second meeting.
Okay, we also have a TM Akshay also. So I was that was the reason I was talking about last 6 months.
yeah, sure. No. Okay.
Okay. Enjoyable and educational meeting plan.
So from I think from club's perspective, educational sessions are planned. Even for last term, if you see, we had Joy coming in for table topics. We had a couple of sessions before the contest.
Yeah. So 4.5 is fine or 5?
4.5 is good. Abhinav.
Yeah, it's okay. Means education sessions. How many education sessions we conducted in last 6 months?
We have conducted around four sessions, right?
Yeah.
Then it is 4.5 is good.
In fact, if you take Prabdeep and the local member sessions also, though even those are also included. So it's good, I think. 4.5 is good.
Yeah.
There's always a scope of improvement. So we cannot make it 5, but...
Regularly should schedule a social event?
ये क्या होगा ये ऑनलाइन मीटिंग में आई डोंट नो
सोशल इवेंट मींस लाइक वो सीआईडी वाले नहीं है सीआईडी वाले इवेंट आई थिंक मे बी It comes under that, or when we celebrate 100 meeting or 200 meeting,
correct.
How that dance, everything is conducted.
हाँ वो भी है and the other thing is ये online में तो I'm not sure how it can be done.
Exactly. और social event I don't think milestone होगा right? I think बाहर कोई आप event कर रहे हो as a Toastmasters.
Something one time they went to resort some place maybe that.
हाँ ये तो छोड़ देते हैं अगर दिए भी तो फिर पूछेंगे ऑनलाइन के हिसाब से हाउ वी विन देन
कैन एनीबॉडी टेल मी व्हाट इज अ माइलस्टोन कुछ इवेंट होता है क्या वो
हाँ जी सो इट्स लाइक एवरी 25th मीटिंग 25th ना राइट वी सेलिब्रेट अ माइलस्टोन दैट इज यू नो वी हैव अचीव्ड टिल दैट पॉइंट एंड यू नो क्लब हैज सक्सेसफुली प्रोग्रेस्ड फॉर एवरी 25th मीटिंग
ओके
So my Toastmasters are two terms. First 6 months are from October to March, and the second is from July to December, and then January to June. And every term has one milestone meeting. So it's like you celebrate it. You know, you have some performances, you have good speeches. थोड़ा अच्छा सा अलग सा हो जाता है.
Okay.
When it is in the physical meetings, it was really a big event. Online में भी होता है.
Yeah.
Last time your eloquence was cancelled, so na bade level pe nahi hua. But I think we did have area and district where Manish participated, and our members were also there.
Yes, I agree.
Yes,
I think many people attend from our many club. Riket exactly. Also, Riket Nara, everyone.
Correct. And the excom also attends, jo bhi area district pe hota hai unke liye.
Yeah, I agree.
4.5 or 5?
Nee, 5.
You can write.
Five.
In district level also people win, na?
Yes.
District level people win.
Yes.
So 5 it is, I think. In my view, it is 5. I don't know others' view. In my view, it is 5 because many people participated.
Many people agreed.
Inter-club events encourage?
This can be 4. We do encourage. We had that debate with the opulent. We do have joint meetings. But you know, it's not much, right? So I think 4. What do you say?
Yeah, I agree.
We have a joint meeting na, with Toastmaster Club of Wakar, Pimpri.
Last 6 months, Pavan, we had meeting, but it is all about last 6 months.
No, last 6 months also we had one meeting.
We did have. Wakar ke saath bhi hua tha, Pimpri
ke saath bhi hua tha. Yeah, I participated.
And then you can put 5 then. Na. We had it, then we can put 5.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think we are good now. Club newsletters, website published and updated regularly.
So it is either a club newsletter or website is either or they are expecting both.
So we don't have a website. So we have newsletter.
Then it is in that case 5 now. Means we publish newsletter. So that should be 5.
This is regular for sure.
Yeah, that we is regular. Months. It should be 5.
And now we have YouTube also. So, you know, social media. Mm-hmm. Instagram is also picking up now.
Okay.
And social event, you can mark it, not at NA, you can mark it for time being. And let them define the social event. According to them, we can again give the point.
Right.
So we can again let Manpreet join. I am asking for help. Manpreet will join.
So we can discuss in common, right?
No, we can discuss now. That is for help. No? Manpreet is that she can come and she can explain about that. That is the that objective of moderator. She will join our breakout box and she will explain that and she again will join another breakout. Yes, so Manpreet, we need one help.
Yeah.
So one point.